The couple have joined Ethic, an ethical investment company, as impact partners with the company. A tweet from the company read, "We're thrilled to welcome Prince Harry and Meghan, the Duke and Duchess of Sussex, as impact partners at Ethic. Together, we are committed to creating a more inclusive, resilient and sustainable future." Their new venture has been met by a mix of responses on Twitter. At Karen Cambridge 5 tweeted, "Removing all my investments with this company as of today. So much for ethics." At Tour Bakahai tweeted, "Impact partners trying to persuade people to stop using private jets, living in 16-bathroom mansions, selling their royal titles for easy dollars, treating their own families like dirt." However, the couple have gained praise from some Twitter users. At Linal02 tweeted, "Love to see it. Bringing awareness for younger generations who are more interested in investing nowadays." At Sussex Squadpod 1 tweeted, "Congratulations. This is incredible. Royals are expected to play a major role in the upcoming climate change event, with negotiations to take place between the senior royals and the nations in attendance. Those set to be in attendance include the Queen, the Princess of Wales, the Duchess of Cornwall, and the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge. At the event, both Prince Charles and Prince William are expected to speak at the conference in the fight against climate change. With the monarchy in attendance, experts predict they will bring a more influential role to the event that would not have been there without them." According to a study in 2018, Ipsos Mori found that 30% believe the royal family allows Britain to be seen in a more positive light. The couple were expected to venture back over to the UK to attend a party in honour of Prince Harry TM's mother, Princess Diana, on Tuesday. The party will have 100 guests in attendance, with Rocketman trademark Elton John and Prince Harry both expected to be at the party. It reportedly took part in discussions on Tuesday with former Channel 4 Commissioner David Glover, who was the brains behind the hit TV show Gogglebox. The 39-year-old is believed to have taken inspiration from her husband Prince William after he teamed up with David Attenborough for his environmental series on the BBC titled The Earthshot Prize, Repairing Our Planet. The mother of three is a keen advocate for improving early childhood development, and it is thought the preliminary talks centered on this topic. A source told the Daily Mail TMS Eden Confidential, "Catherine is very interested in a program. She thinks it could be a really significant way to explore an important subject. She's been very impressed with William's efforts and knows how much he enjoyed making his Earthshots series." Kate said, "Our early childhoods shape our adult lives, and knowing more about what impacts this critical time is fundamental to understanding what we as a society can do to improve our future health and happiness. I am committed to supporting greater in-depth research in this vital area, and I'm delighted to be meeting all those behind the study at this early stage." The Duchess of Cambridge has spent a decade raising awareness on the subject and established her Royal Foundation Centre for Early Childhood. Don't miss the Duke of Cambridge TM's new 5-part Earthshot documentary was released this week. The climate change series follows on from the 50 million Earthshot prize pool, which awards 1 million to each of the 5 successful ideas to tackle climate change. 5 new innovations will be funded each year for the next decade. William said, "It is within our reach, but only if we reach for it now." Over the next 10 years, the Earthshot Prize will celebrate, champion and scale 50 innovative solutions to the biggest environmental challenges facing our planet. But in truth, it TMLL take a lot more than 50 solutions. It will take every one of us, as individuals, as schools, as communities, as businesses, and as leaders, to do our bit. To change our choices and our habits, to set and achieve our own personal Earthshots, we can change the world again. What could be seen as a bid to fill the gap left by the teenager, the Dutch royals decided to welcome a new member to the family, a little dog named Mambo. They introduced the puppy to their social media followers on World Animal Day, October 4th, saying, "Meet Mambo, the newest member of the royal family," alongside a cute photo of the tiny animal wearing a pink collar. The arrival of the pet comes just after Princess Alexia's move to the UK in August. Alexia is studying for her international baccalaureate at the UWC Atlantic College in Llantwit Major, Wales. She will spend the next 2 years there, joined by the heir to the Spanish throne Princess Leonor, 15, who is the eldest daughter of King Felipe and Queen Letizia. The college's campus facilities, with an impressive library, woodland, two swimming pools, and historic buildings that host the classrooms where about 350 international students undertake their lessons, is definitely fit for royal purpose. That the Dutch royal family loves animals is no news. King Willem Alexander, Queen Maxima, Princess Alexia and her sisters Katharina, Amalia, 17, and Princess Ariane, 14, are already the proud owners of three Labradors called Luna, Skipper, and Nala. On last year's World Animal Day, they shared a sweet photo of the three pooches playing with a ball on their royal estate, Landgoed de Horstin, in Wassenaar. Dogs have long played a part in the lives of European royal families. In Spain, King Felipe VI has had several pets: Schnauzer dog Pushkin, Pinky, Val. One of the most remembered pets at the palace is Arki, a silent witness to important events in the history of the Spanish transition. At home, the monarch, Queen Elizabeth II, is renowned for her love of corgis, while the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge welcomed a new puppy last year. Camilla, the Duchess of Cornwall, owns two rescue pups called Beth and Bluebell. Meanwhile, Prince Harry and Meghan share their Montecito home with Guy, a Labrador they adopted in August 2018, and Pula, whose name has a special meaning to the couple, as it's a nod to their first trip together. Pula is the currency of Botswana, the country where their love story took strength. When the Sussexes started dating, they spent 5 nights camping there. Besides, Harry admitted that when he sought refuge after the death of his mother, Princess Diana, he found it there. The Netherlands royal household last week confirmed that a new book, titled Amalia, will be released to mark Princess Katharina Amalia's 18th birthday on December 7th. Launching in mid-November, it will be based on the princess's encounters with writer, comedian and singer Claudia de Bry, who has been in charge of the writing. Amalia became heir apparent at the age of 9, following the abdication of her grandmother Queen Beatrix and the accession to the throne of her father. Kate Middleton, 39, and Prince William, 39, visited Northern Ireland last week where they were given the opportunity to sample some Northern Irish food and drink from whiskey and soda bread potato crisps. In a video clip posted by royal correspondent Richard Palmer, the Cambridges were told to help themselves to samples of whiskey, but only William picked up a glass. Us Weekly royal correspondents Molly Mulshine and Christina Garibaldi discussed the speculations made over the clip and dismissed claims it could be due to pregnancy on the Royally Us podcast. Ms. Mulshine said, "They visited Derry, which is in Northern Ireland, and they hit every aspect of Irish life. Kate apparently didn't drink the whiskey and some people were speculating on that, but I don't know. Do you think it's probably just because drinking whiskey in broad daylight at work is not the best look?" Ms. Garibaldi said, "I think that's it. We spoke to one of our royal experts a couple of weeks ago and he doesn't think they're going to go for baby number 4. Maybe she just didn't feel like it was the right time or the place." It comes as royal commentator Nick Bullen, the co-founder of True Royalty TV, suggested the Duchess may be happy with matching her parents, Michael and Carol Middleton, and stop at 3 children. Asked whether Prince William and Kate may soon announce a new baby on the way, Mr. Bullen told Royally US, "Look, I don't know, I'm not privy to that information. But I think they feel they got a pretty perfect family. Kate was always very keen to follow her parents and have that family of 5. She's matched it, and my own view is, they probably will stop here. She had a really tough time with all of her pregnancies." Don't miss the Duchess of Cambridge suffered from the debilitating condition known as hyperemesis gravidarum during her pregnancies with Prince George, Princess Charlotte, and Prince Louis. The condition left her debilitated due to the constant nausea and vomiting, which even forced her to be hospitalized while expecting her eldest son in 2013. Mr. Bullen also noted the Duke and Duchess of Cambridge, as two leading members of the royal family, will likely have a prominent role in the celebrations for the Queen's Platinum Jubilee next year. He continued, "Both of them turn 40 next year and they are really keen to be promoting their charities, their initiatives, their foundations. The next 12 months is all about the work, not about a new baby."